I'm Kathleen Beller. In a few minutes, you're going to meet one of my best friends, who also happens to be one of the finest makeup artists in the world. Her name is Victoria Jackson, and she's not only going to teach you the best way to use her makeup, she's going to show you how to look your best without looking overly made up. Now, I've been an actress for almost 20 years, and when I'm in front of the camera, there's always a makeup artist on the set to make me look my best. I don't have to worry about it. But when I'm at home, on my own, that's a whole other story. So you and I are going to learn this together. But before Victoria joins us, let's sit in on one of her recent makeover seminars. I am so glad all of you could come today. Now, I know we had you come with your hair pulled back and no makeup, and that was probably hard for some of you driving here this morning. But the reason is I wanted you to be able to look in the mirror and really be able to recognize your strengths and your weaknesses and know how to really play up those strengths and play down those weaknesses. Now, you're going to learn some makeup techniques today that are going to make some dramatic differences in how you look. And you're going to learn some great hairstyles to really look the best on your face. Now, before we start, we're going to take some before photographs. Everyone is going to see such a major difference today and be so amazed at how they look. We're going to take an after photo. Now, you can't take me home with you, and a lot of people wish I was there at 8 o'clock in the morning to help them get ready for work. But what I can do is send you home with one of my videotapes that's going to take you through step by step and make it so easy for you to recreate the makeup. And you'll have wonderful reminder cards you can put right on your mirror that's going to make it really easy. The best part is you are going to get your best look from start to finish faster and easier than you ever had before. Now, let's go and take some of those before photos. Look at all of you, you look so great. What an incredible difference. And you know what I really like? It doesn't even look like you're made up. That's what's so great about my cosmetics. It shows your natural skin through. It doesn't feel like a heavy painted mask. You just have color on your skin without any texture. You know, it's really true. If you have the right cosmetics with the right techniques, a little bit goes a long way. I think we have got to take a look at some of these really great before and afters.
I love the way you look. I see you change, a second take I took. I see you change, baby. Oh, baby. Baby, I love the way you look. Love the way you look. Should be on the cover of a book. Love the way you look. Love the way you look. Can't believe my eyes. I see you change. Such a nice surprise. I see you change, baby. Oh, baby. Baby, baby. I love the way you look. Love the way you look. Was that the earth that shook? Or just the way you look? The way you look. Should be on the cover of a book. I love the way you look. The way you look. Was that the earth that shook? I love the way you look. Love the way you look.
Love the way you look.
And now joining me is Victoria Jackson.
Hi, Kathleen.
How are you? So what are we going to do today? What are we going to learn?
All right. Well, first, we're going to start by explaining some of the things you've received in your kit. Then we're going to look at how to prepare your skin for makeup. The better your face is prepared before you make up, the less makeup you're going to have to use, and the more beautiful and natural your look is going to be. Now, after we finish talking about preparation, I'm going to take you through a complete makeover where I make someone up from the start to finish and show you all the right techniques for a general makeup application. Now, most people make major mistakes, and we're going to show you how to avoid all those mistakes. Now, it's really important that you view this section of the tape in its entirety. You don't want to miss any little tips. Makeover, we're going to show you how to correct various problems and flaws, something we can all relate to. Now, here's something that I'm really excited about, because we are the only ones in the country who are doing this. When you ordered your kit, you probably ordered from our TV show or our magazine ads. Well, it costs us a lot of money to broadcast those shows and run those ads. However, when one of your friends buys one of our introductory kits because of your recommendation, we get their order without spending a dime on advertising, and that saves us a lot of money. So we created a referral program that passes a lot of those savings right back to you. We call it our Tell-A-Friend Order Program, and it's explained in this brochure. Now, on the back page of this brochure, you'll fill in your name in the referral box on our Tell-A-Friend Order form. Now, when one of your friends or relatives uses that form to order our introductory color kit, we will then send you a $25 gift certificate that you can use against any purchase of our products. And there's no limit on how many you can earn.
Do you know that if I had a $25 gift certificate for every time I've recommended your makeup, I would never have to pay for makeup again in my life?
Wouldn't that be great?
Yes.
Well, that's why we're so excited about this program, and we really hope you'll tell all your friends about our products.
All right, well, I already do that. So what's next?
All right, let me tell you what's next. Now we're going to talk about how to prepare your skin for makeup and how to take care of it. Because, you know, having made up thousands of faces, I've learned that proper skincare and pre-makeup preparation of the face always results in achieving a better look with less makeup. And the less makeup you need to apply for your best look, the better. So I ended up creating my own skincare products because I wasn't getting the results I wanted from the other products on the market. I have really sensitive skin, and I know you do too, Kathleen.
Yeah, I have a hard time finding anything that works.
I know, it's really difficult. So it was critical for me that all my products be water-based, not oily, so that they would be lighter, they'd be non-greasy, they'd be great, even for the most sensitive skin.
So which one of these do you use first?
Oh, well, let me tell you, okay, this is how you start. This product, Kathleen, I love it. What it is it's an eye makeup remover and a facial cleanser.
Both for the same thing?
Yeah, it's great, because, you know, usually you'd have to buy something that would remove your eye makeup,
right,
and then something, you know, to take off the rest of your makeup.
Right.
And this is great because it does both. So it's gentle enough for your face, but it will also take off your eye makeup.
Does it get off the mascara?
Oh, it gets it off great. And the thing is, it's like water. So, I mean, it just feels great. There's nothing greasy. I mean, I'm always stressing in the makeup that I like a really flat, matte look, and I don't like to use anything that's going to start you off with a real oily or kind of greasy. And this is like water, but it takes it all off, and it's just one thing, so it's great.
Great.
I love it. Now, after you do that, you've taken off, you're going to use this in the morning in place of soap. So after you've used this, we have the toning mist, and you should use it after cleansing your face. Now, this will close your pores, reduce your skin's output of oil, and allow a smoother, more even application of your makeup. You can also use it after you apply your foundation to reduce any heaviness, or after you apply the powder to take the texture of the powder off your skin and set your makeup. Now, I also like to use it during the day as a freshener. It feels great, and it keeps your makeup looking its best. Now, to me, something that's really important is your moisturizer.
Yes.
I mean, I don't know, I think you probably feel the same way. You want something that really absorbs quickly into your skin.
Right, so your makeup doesn't slide off
your
face.
Yeah, and it doesn't feel greasy, and that's what this stuff is. It's just great. I mean, you put it on, and it is gone, and it's really light. I never break out from this, and I think I said earlier that I have really sensitive skin, and I know you do too.
Right.
And I wanted to find something that, you know, I would put on, and I'd use very little, and it's just great. I don't even know I have it on, and I use it all day long.
That's wonderful.
So I really start with the cleanser.
Okay.
And I use my toning mist.
Okay.
And then I go with my moisturizer. It's real simple. Now, when I want to do a little bit more, I use my mask. Now, the mask is great, for what this does is it helps exfoliate the dead skin cells that are on your face. It's also relaxing, so you're going to put this on. This is kind of a treatment where it's something you have to do every day.
How often would you do it?
You might want to use it every couple of days.
Okay.
And what it does is it really firms and tightens. And I've told people, if you put it even on like half of the side of your face, and you try just working with it on one side and you leave the other, when you take it off, you're going to see such a difference in just how your face feels. It's like baby soft skin. It's great.
That's wonderful.
Yeah. You know, the whole thing with this skincare line is I just wanted it to be really fast and easy, along with the makeup. So you would just use these products very quickly, and they'd work. Now, this is my favorite because I love this cute little bottle. It's Eye Gel Repair, and it's great for taking away some of the puffiness, bags around the eyes.
So you would use this in the morning when you woke up and your eyes were a little puffy?
Exactly.
Okay.
And you could just spot it around your eyes. You could also use it in the evening just when you've, you know, before you're going to go to bed. And it's, again, the whole line, there's nothing greasy about it. It just, it's absorbed very quickly into your skin, right. And everything is to be used very fast.
Okay, now, we've prepared our faces. What's the next step?
Okay, let me tell you what I'm going to tell the people at home. Before we actually go through a makeover, I want you to do something that I teach all my makeup students at UCLA. And one of the first things I have my students do is come to class with no makeup on. They don't like that too much. And with their hair pulled back. Now, the purpose is to help them look at their face and recognize their strengths and weaknesses. We then concentrate on how we can minimize their weaknesses and play up their strengths. Now, this is where you should start right now. So why don't you stop the tape, take your makeup off, tie or clip your hair back, and come back with a mirror in your hand and get ready to work.
Do I have to do that?
You have to do it, but you'll have fun. Well, we're all back and we're ready to work, and we're here with Lori now and ready to get started. Now, as you can see, she's got her hair pulled back, and hopefully you at home have your hair pulled back and you're ready to get to work. And you've probably gone through and tried to make a list of what you think all your strengths and all your weaknesses are. And everybody has a great deal of weaknesses that they are always ready to tell me about, all the problem areas. But I want you to try and think about some of those strengths. And if you don't know what they are, try to think about something that somebody just complimented you on recently. Did they tell you you had great eyes, or a great mouth, or you've got great cheekbones? Well, that's probably a strength, and that might be something that you want to work on when we get into how to do all of these techniques. Now, what I want to do first is I want to get you to feel comfortable with what we're going to do. We're going to go through all of the products, and I want you to remember that this is only makeup, okay? You can always wash it off and start over again, because it's supposed to be fun and it's supposed to be easy. And I want you to know, if it makes you feel any better at all, that a lot of the students at my classes at UCLA were guys, and they would come to the class having never done makeup before, and their hands were shaking, and it's like, oh, I've never put on lipstick or foundations, and I'm glad to know that they hadn't. But and they were real good at working on other people and really creating a great look, because they took the time and they listened and they watched me do this and they learned some great techniques. So that's what we're going to do. But just to review right now some of the products that you've received in your kit, let's go through them, because we're going to start with our foundation. Now, foundation is real important, because it's the foundation that's going to even out Lori's skin tone, and it's going to give us the great start we need for the rest of the makeup, because she's got a few blemishes, as we all tend to do at times, or red marks. The foundation is great for evening out the skin tone and just making you look really your best, because even if you do great eyes, but your skin tones don't match, it isn't going to be a very good makeover. And that's what's so wonderful about this base. They're very close to your skin tones, so they'll just neutralize any problem areas you have on the face and just make you look like you have flawless skin. Now, we're going to go from that to powders. Pressed powders. The powders work with the foundation to really give you a very flawless, flat, matte look. They absorb any shine. They're very fine powders that are great to work with, because they don't leave a lot of dusting of powder all over the place. They just absorb the shine, which is what you want them to do. Now, we're going to go from that going into eyeshadows. We're going to be working with all of our eyeshadows. Now, you know, the whole line is really peach, pink, or red. But you're going to see when I'm working here, I like to mix all the colors together, because it's really fun. And hopefully those of you at home that just have a peach kit, you're really going to want a pink or red kit, because it's fun to interchange all the colors, to just blend a color that's very uniquely yours and have fun doing it. That's what I do when I'm on my fashion shoots for Vogue or Elle or whatever the magazine. I'm creating from all my different colors here. So we're going to be working with the eyeshadows. Then we're going to go on to working with lips, which you can tell is great. This is the fun idea here of just mixing and matching these colors to create any new color that you like. So it's something to just have a good time with. Not only that, you're going to be so thrilled when you start working with this and seeing the great colors you can come up with and just throwing it in your purse. You're going to love it. Now, after we do all of that fun stuff, we're going to go over to the mascara. We've got your clear gel on one side, which is great for your eyebrows and your thickening your lashes, and your mascara. So you're going to learn how to work with both of these, and once you do, you're not going to want to part with this item. Now, after all of that, you want to start working with these eye pencils. The eye pencils are great. They're going to help really define your eyes. You're going to find how easy they are to blend and really smudge and give you a great look that you want, very soft. And that's with
these lip pencils as well. Now, we've got lip pencils that are going to match, as you know by now, each lip color. And they're great for lining your lips to really give you a good start in filling in with your color. And to put it all on with, you're going to have your great set of brushes. You've got your great blush brush, an eyebrow brush and a comb, a lip brush, and I love this idea. I kind of designed a two-sided eyeshadow brush, fill-in color and a slant tip, which is going to help give you a nice line. So this will be kind of fun and easy for you. Now, I always work with all of these products on all of my jobs, and I'm making up all my famous faces. This is what I work with. So the only cheat that you're going to see me use is this sponge, which you don't have in your kit. And I work with these. You can buy these. These are little wedge sponges. And we tried so hard to see how we could fit this sponge into your kits, but we couldn't quite do it. So we do have in here the next best thing, a sponge I love for touch-ups, which is in your compact. That'll be great to help you get through the day. But those of you that want to go to the store and buy these wedge-cut sponges, it's real easy. They're real available, and they're kind of fun and easy to work with. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to start in our demonstration today is we're going to do just half of Lori's face. And the reason for that is I've always found that it's great when you can constantly see the change the makeup is making. Now, remember, makeup is just there to create an illusion. And obviously, the illusion Lori probably wants to create is one that she's going to look and feel really beautiful, yet keeping really a natural look and something that's going to be Lori, not something that's going to be me. So that's what we're going to try to create. So I want you to be able to start now, follow through this with me, stay through in this portion of the tape, and then we're going to later on, as we've said earlier, go to some of those problem areas. So we're going to start now with putting on her foundation. Great, now before we start your foundation, what I'm gonna do is, I told you how much I love my skincare products, so I'm gonna use a little of this toning mist, close your eyes, and it's great. It's just a freshener, and it's gonna just help make the foundation go on really a little bit smoother. So, now we're gonna take the foundation, and we're gonna just start evening out. Now, as you can see, you've got your two shades, and the reason you've got two shades here, and one shade is a half a shade lighter than the other, you're gonna find your lightest shade on top, and a little slightly darker on the bottom. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kind of mix back and forth, getting the excess off on my hand and matching exactly to Lori's jawline. Now, as you can see here, this is a perfect match for Lori. This is the medium tones. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna keep mixing and just keep blending. Now, whichever way you decide to blend, that's fine, as long as you remember you want to ultimately end on a downward movement because of any facial hair. And you just want to make sure that you're going, if you've got short hair, you want to be sure to get into the earlobe. And the good thing about this is if you get a good color match, you shouldn't have to go too far down on the neck because you don't want to have to get a lot of your clothes all full of your makeup. Great. So as you can see, it's just really covering. You want to be sure to go right around the nose area, right in through here. And again, I'm using this wedge cut. And what's good about this is that it's cut so that it really goes up to every angle of your face. A lot of times, most women are not used to working with sponges. And when I first started doing makeup, I always used my fingers, which a lot of you at home, I'm sure, do. But it really, once you start working with a sponge, you'll never go back to anything else because it just blends incredibly. And see how nicely it goes right over any of the acne? And it just covers beautifully. Now, if you have to spot touch an area, what we call that is stippling. You're just sort of patting an area. You're not just brushing over it. And that's okay to do when you have an area that's going to need a little more attention. And then we're going to set it with powder. Now, go right up into your hairline and blend it through. Now, also, if you've got a lot of, say, a dark discoloration over your eyes, and you may want to lighten that out a little, don't have any problem with taking your foundation and going right over the eye area. Okay, now, for a little bit of lightening under the eyes. Now, you can see what I do first is I put on the base, and I try to even out the skin, and then I go in and I do some work underneath the eyes. Okay, and I start just stippling in toward the nose. And this is going to help to really counter any under-eye dark circles.
Now, the mistake that most women make is that they have under-eye dark circles. Everybody says to me, oh, Victoria, I have all these dark circles under my eyes. I can never get rid of them. But what they're doing is they're taking this real light white makeup and they're going underneath their eyes. And it never quite takes it away. And all what it really does is it just adds a highlight. So you're almost drawing more attention to it. And as well, this makeup is great for if you've got freckles. And don't be afraid if you've got any freckles. You still want to let your natural skin show through with this base. You don't have to do a real heavy coverage. Now, if you do have a little bit, say, a rougher skin, you've got a little more acne, it's okay to use the foundation a little bit heavier. But remember, a little bit of this goes a long way. So at first, that's a mistake that some women will make. They'll take a lot of it. Now take a look at what's on my sponge. That's all the makeup that I'm using. This makeup should last you a little while. You don't want to go in and just really get a whole gob of it on your sponge. You just want to get a little bit and blend. So again, it's like I said earlier, as long as you always apply and blend, you'll be fine. Okay, now we're just about ready. Now we're going into the hairline. Obviously make sure you get up into the hairline, but try not to do anything where you're seeing some orange hair all around. You just want to blend it in so that you've got a nice, even finished look. Now when you think you have it, stop. That's another big mistake most women make. They just keep going and they keep piling it on. So you've got to know when to stop. Now one thing I wanted to show you is say in a special troubled area, you may want to take a Q-tip and your foundation and just spot over it. Say there's a particular area or a blemish that's giving you a problem. You can do that. Now also, you may want to, those of you that have a brush, you may want to work with a brush and just smooth in or use your sponge. But I just want to give you some alternatives here. Now let's just finish off, make sure her base looks really even, her skin is nice and flat looking. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is I want everyone to see, really look at the difference. This is before we've done any powder or anything. You can really see how the base is just evened out. Now it's not a heavy look. It's just, you're still seeing her skin shine through, but it's just giving just the right amount of coverage. Now, let me just give you a little trick here. Say you were doing what I just did and made look very simple, and all of a sudden you've got a lot of makeup on and you don't know what to do. It's real easy, don't panic. Just take your little spritzer, your toning mist, go over it. Take your sponge and start wiping off some of the excess. So there's nothing you can't fix. Remember, all the top makeup artists, all the pros, you know, we all make mistakes and maybe we put on a little too much at times or something's not quite blending the way we want. There's nothing you can't fix because it's just makeup. Okay, now let's go into using our powder. Now what I want to do with the powder is really just set the foundation. Now I use a puff. The reason that I use a puff that comes with the foundation is that it really helps set the makeup. I don't like the powder to just dust over the skin. I want to see it really be pressed lightly into the skin. Take your powder, get some of it on the puff, dust the excess off. A big mistake women make is they get a lot of powder and they go right to the face and it's kind of like makeup all over the face. So you just want to get a real fine amount. You can see what I'm using here and on my sponges. Very little makeup. A little bit's gonna go a long way. And you're just gonna go over to really set the makeup. Now what's great too about using your toning mist in between is you're really setting your foundation, meaning you're making it last a little bit longer, so you're gonna get a little more coverage throughout the day. And your makeup's gonna last. That's what's so great about this base. You will find you put it on in the morning and you can go all day and it's still where you want it to be and it's giving you the coverage. And people are just telling you how great your skin looks. Great. Mm-hmm. Make sure you don't see any powder. It's very fine, so you shouldn't have any problem. You're going right over where you've done your foundation. Now let's take a look. That's before. And that's after.
Now let's go on to the next step.
Now we're going to talk about eyebrows. Now, eyebrows are the most neglected feature of the face, and they're the most important because they really frame your eyes. So what we're going to do is I want everybody to take a look at their eyebrows at home. You need to look at, are they too thin? Are they too full? Let me show you where they should begin and where they should end. Now you take your pencil and just hold it in the corner of the eye, straight up, and almost draw an imaginary line right like this. This is where your eyebrows should begin. Now, when you keep your pencil at that portion of the eye and you turn it, you go exactly on the diagonal, almost to the outer corner of the eye is where it should end. Now, Lori's eye here, I can see, is just a little bit shy of eyebrow, so we're going to need to fill that in. So we're going to be using our taupe eyebrow pencil, our brown pencil, brown eyeshadow if you have it, and if you don't worry about it. Your pencils will work fine. It's just sometimes it's nice to use a powder for an extra option of a fill-in color. And then we're also going to be working with our eyebrow brush and comb. Now what I do is, and say looking at Lori's coloring here where she's got light colored hair, I never like to go too dark in my pencil. Remember, it's always better to go light and build up your color as opposed to going too dark and having to take it down. It's always better to add more. So let's just start with filling in with some color, and I'm also going to be blending with my sponge. Now I'm going to start right here in the center of the eye, and I'm going to just go, you can see I'm working very lightly in making very small wispy strokes in filling in with color. And I'm almost going to paint on where the eyebrow should be. And it's got to be very natural. So you've got to blend it, you've got to apply it, and then blend your stroke right out. Now you'll be amazed at just what a difference applying pencil is going to do for your eyebrows, which in turn is going to change the whole look of your eyes. Now using your brush, you're going to brush up your brow. What this does is it helps so that you're going to keep the brush is nice, the brow nicely groomed, and you're going to place your color where you want it. Now I noticed here I have a we have a little red mark. We're going to just blend that out. If ever you're using any of your products, now here we're going back to the foundation because I saw a little flaw that I wanted to cover up. Now once you start to use your taupe pencil and get the line that you want filling in, take your clear gel, and this is great for using to groom your brows, sort of give you your brushed up brow effect here. And then what a real good little tip is, it helps to take your powder, your brown powder, if you're going to work with some powder, to help fill in, depositing a little bit more color and just giving a nicer look to the brow. And then again, blend. I'm going to have her turn a little toward me. Right. And you can just see this, what this is doing is it's also really giving me a good idea of how now I want to do my eyes, because this is now framing the eye better for me. Okay. Now remember, the thing you have to do with eyebrows, and problem is when I'm working on most women, they'll say, gee, I've never seen my eyebrows look so made up or so heavy. Wait till you get your eyebrows done and then do your eyes, and usually you're going to find, as you're going to see here with Lori, how it's just going to work together really well. Great. Now let's take the clear gel and just brush up, which is great for really grooming. You can really get some nice effects with this. It's kind of a conditioner as well. And as I said earlier, it's great for helping to adhere some of your powder over the brows, which again keeps it real soft and real natural. Now when you're using your eyebrow brush, it's great to just very lightly go over, separating. And remember, another great tip, if you're not using your eye gel or with your eye gel, it's very in the morning you can take your brush, put it in some soap, and then go right over the eyebrows, and it just helps give it a real fine little adhesive so that you can control them better. Another trick some makeup artists do is they take some hairspray and they'll spray the brush, not the eyes, and again, that works. But as you can tell, the important thing here is I just want you to do your eyebrows very natural, enough to frame your eyes, using the guidelines of where to begin and where to end. And really, you can see the difference from before and after. Now let's go on to the next step. Some people prefer to go on to eyeshadow at this point, but I do eyeliner at this point because I like to bring out the eyes. We've just done the framing of her eyes with the eyebrow, and I like to use the eyeliner now, which is really going to define her eyes, because then I don't use as much eyeshadow, and I like to see the less makeup the better, so that's why I'm doing it this way. So I'm going to start with one of my dark brown pencils, and I'm going to line her eyes. Now remember, the liner is meant to just accent and define the eyes. This is what's going to really draw the attention. And what's important here is that you use your pencil right down at the bottom of the bases of the lashes. Now I'm going to have Lori close her eyes. Great. Now here you're going to see me just apply a little pressure and go right down into the lash line with my pencil, which really helps give the illusion of thicker lashes. Now the important thing is you want to get right down in the base of the lashes. But ladies, don't be upset if you're a little bit off. All you're going to have to do is blend. So we're going to go right down into the lashes. Then we're going to take our sponge, and we're just going to blend it out so that it's very smoky. Okay, now open your eyes. And you can see how it's just given her a nice hint. Now I'm going to go while her eyes are open. While your eyes are open, go right down in that lash line with your pencil. Now I'm using my dark brown. If your coloring is a little bit darker, you may want to use your brown and your black. And for an evening look, it would be very easy to go right over this with a little bit of your black, very simply, just to create a little bit more of a dramatic look. But what we're going for here with Lori is a nice daytime look. And then you just want to keep making sure that you're blending after you've applied. Now, let's go to the center, look straight up, and there's a center from the corner of the eye right to the tip of the lashes. You want to apply your pencil and then blend. Close your eyes, and then just blend. Now you can see we have very little pencil on, but yet it's really defined her eyes. Now let's work underneath. We do here what we call stippling. We're just going to dot in between the lashes with the pencil. Just enough to define her eyes just a little bit more. Now the look of a real heavy line is a little bit dated now. And remember, if we were to go ahead and put dark on the inside rim, right down in the inside rim of the eye, we would be closing her eye up. So you don't want to go in the inside rim, you just want to go right between the lashes. Now a good tip to remember is, if you've got a lot of dark underneath your eyes, or a lot of under eye dark circles or puffs or bags, you don't want to do too much color under your eyes, because what it will do is draw more attention. So we're just very lightly doing enough here just to give a little more definition to her eyes. Okay, now let's look before and after. See how nicely it defines her eyes? Let's go on to the next step now. Now let's go on to eyeshadow. Now you've got a couple of different tools to work with here. You have my slant tip brush and my brush that I use for a little bit more fill-in color. And you've got the wonderful little brushes that come in the compact. Now let's work with the slant tip brush. Now what you want to do with your eyeshadow, Lori has eyes that are just a little bit close set together. And I'm going to just create the illusion of wider set eyes. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to work with my brush here, my slant tip brush, I'm putting more of the dark color on the outer portion of the eye, which is going to draw the illusion that when you're looking at her to this part of the eye, which is going to widen her face. So I'm going to work in my browns, and I'm also going to work in my peach kit and my pink kit. And I like to blend my colors. I get the excess off, and then I'm going to go right to her eyes, starting at the outer portion of the eye. Now it's real important that you watch. Now a lot of people have a problem with, they say that a lot of dusting goes onto their eye. Now if you have a problem with a lot of eyeshadow and powder falling down, a good trick is to hold a Kleenex at the outer portion of the eye and just work starting at the outer portion of the eye in toward the nose. Now, a lot of people tend to work starting at this point, working out, and they follow the natural contour of the eye. And it doesn't change the eye, you're just following the natural line. So what we're gonna do is actually reshape her eye. Now, you can work with a Kleenex like this to help give you a line as a guide, or something that I find is also very easy is if you use your sponge and you hold it diagonally, just like this, and you work in toward the nose, keeping the concentration of dark color on the outer portion of the eye. Now, always make sure to blend. Now, don't worry if you get little pieces of shadow falling underneath the eye. It happens. It's happening to me now when I do this tape. It always will happen. Just let it dry and then flake it away with the other side of your brush. Now, once you've done this and you've gotten the initial color down on the outer portion of the eye, you need to open your eye, and then with your eyes open, contour the outer portion working in toward the nose. Now, the reason we do that is a lot of women tend to work doing their eyes with their eyes closed, and it looks great with the eyes closed, but when they open their eyes, the makeup isn't quite in the right place. So I'm gonna have Lori keep her eye open while I continue to add my eyeshadow. And this way I'm gonna make sure that I'm getting the shadow where I need to. Now, this is extremely effective for a woman who, say, you have a few puffs above the eye, or your eyelid is drooping, and you're not quite getting the color where you need to. You need to look in the mirror, keep your eye open, and place your shadow in that area. Okay, now, once I've got my shadow on the outer portion of the eye, I'm gonna work with this other side, and I'm gonna put a little bit of my fill-in color, which is a little bit of my lighter color. And I'm gonna work with that. Remember now, I'm always doing this because I'm getting the excess powder off before I go to the eye. And what it does is it helps really control the amount. The mistake a lot of women will make is if you use too much and then you go right to the eye and you've got all that powder. Now, I just wanna blend enough color, so I've got my lighter on the center here and I'm working with my darker on the outer portion. Right. Now I just want to blend. And I'm working it right up into the brow. Now the look is no longer where, remember, you used to have a real light highlight and then you'd have a darker crease color and then you might have another color right in the lid. What I'm trying to do here and what looks real natural is when you blend your colors together. So you're getting a nice shadowing effect, but you're not getting all that color. Now, if you like to use just a little bit underneath the eyes, look straight up, you can use your brush, or you can use your Q-tip and use a little bit of your powder and go right under your line that you've already drawn with your pencil. Now, always be sure after you do every step that you're blending. Now, it'd be very easy to go from this to an evening look. All we'd have to do is, I like my red kit, which has a little bit more of the darker colors, and I would take that, and I might just add a little bit of that to the outer portion of her eyes, and you could see here, it just adds a little more depth, and it gives a little bit more of a dramatic look. Now, the look of wings at the outer portion of the eyes is not what we want to achieve, so what you want to do is apply it and always blend. Should be very muted. Now, let's take a look. We see it before. Now let's look after. Now, just to review, what's really important here is that you're using the V shaping on the outer portion of the eye. You're using your darker color on the outer portion of the eye. And when you're working up and you're working in. So you're gonna always follow that shape. It's important because you're gonna see it on your reminder cards and you're gonna see it in some other eye demonstrations we're gonna do. So let's go on to the next step. Now let's talk a little bit about mascara. Now for this section, you're gonna need your mascara comb, And this is optional. Some of you women will like to use this and some of you won't. It's an eyelash curler. But let me show you why I start with an eyelash curler. The reason is it really helps give the eyes a wide open look. Now, if you use it right, you'll love it. If you use it wrong, you're going to wish you'd never used it because it will pinch your eye. But what I'm going to do is you use it right down to the lash line. You give a little squeeze, not for 10 minutes while you're making breakfast, but just a little squeeze. You put it down, and then you go to your mascara. Now remember, the biggest mistake most women make when they're doing their mascara is they just use too much, and they don't separate the lashes in between the coats. So what we're going to do is we're going to work from the top down, and what that does is it helps to get rid of some of the powder that may have fallen from your eyeshadow, and from the bottom up, which builds your lashes. Now before we do that, this is a great little trick and why we have a two-sided mascara. You want to use your clear gel mascara and go over your lashes from the bottom first, and then go top down. Now, say you're running out in the morning, it's you're not going to wear much color of any kind, you just want to go out very quickly. What this clear gel does is it still gives you the illusion of some color, but you don't have any black mascara to worry about that might run around on your face. So you put that on, it also really helps to thicken your lashes, and then we go into our black mascara. Now I'm going to work here from the bottom up, and then after I feel I've just put very little on, what I do is I put it down, I get a Kleenex, I take my brush with the comb, that's what this is for, and I take this, I wrap it around my finger, and I take it right up to the lash line, and I'm going to comb off the excess mascara. So you can see the excess mascara is here, it's not on her face. Now something that will always happen when you're doing your mascara, and I know every woman can relate to this, you're putting on your mascara, and then you look up, and you've got nice little dots of black mascara up there. Don't worry about it. It happens. Just let it dry. Wipe it away. You could use your toning mist, and then you could take your sponge, wipe it right off, and it's gone. So from the bottom up, we're building the lashes, and we're separating. Now already I can see Lori has nice long lashes, so I really don't want to make it too exaggerated and keep building where it just looked really fake. I just want to give a nice little bit of color, and there I can see I've got just a little too much on, so what I'm going to do, again, take my Kleenex and wipe the excess off. Now, for doing your lower lashes, this is a perfect brush for doing your lower lashes. Actually, it's a perfect brush for doing the top lashes as well, because you can really control where the mascara goes. But you just really want to, like we talked about with the eyeliner, stipple in between the lashes. We just want to do that with our mascara. Now again, if you've got very dark under eye circles, puffs, or bags, don't go too heavily with your mascara underneath because it will just draw more attention to that area. That's another very common mistake that women make. Great. And there you have mascara. So let's look before and after. Now let's go on to our next step. Now we're going to go on to doing the blush, and usually by now your face is just screaming for some color. So what I like to do, and this is optional, is sometimes before I go right into the blush, I like to go a little bit darker than my foundation color in doing some of my contouring. Now some of you at home may have, say, just the medium foundation kit, and you may need to go to the tan. So what I'm going to do is I've used the medium on Lori, and now I'm going to use the tan. I'm going to go to my lighter shade in my tan kit, and I'm going to start to prepare her face for the blush. Now to find the blush, what I do is feel down the side of her face for the bone, and I know right in that area, right below that bone, is where I want to do my contouring. Now if you're not sure where, a good tip at home is if you just suck in and feel down the side of your face, and where you see the hollow, that's where you're going to use your contour. So we just slightly put a little dark, very little. Now the mistake you can make here is using too much. So just a little bit, this is going to prepare the face for the blush. Very subtle. Now I also want to do just a little bit of contouring on Lori's nose here. I want to just straighten out. There's a little bit of an unevenness in the line here, so what I'm going to do is use the same color, and I'm just going to very slightly, very lightly, go down the center of her nose with my darker. And it's almost going to be invisible, but that's how it needs to be. It's very subtle. Now what I do here, and let's see, we can show you before, but it's not going to be a dramatic before and after. Here's before, and here's after, just with a little bit of contouring. It's barely visible to the eye. We're going to go over that with our blush. Now this is important when we use the blush. Now again, I like to mix my colors, so I'm going to be using my peach kit and my pink kit, and I'm going to mix back and forth with my colors. Now you get a great little brush that comes in the compact. The only thing is, these are good for touch-ups, but I like to work when I'm doing my makeup in the morning with a bigger brush because you can cover more surface space to the face with this kind of a brush. So what you do is you've got two colors in here, a light and a dark. We want to go over this area where we just very slightly contoured with the darker shade of our blush. That's why there's a darker and a lighter. And what we're going to do is mix the powders, and don't worry if they mix together. Everything has been designed so that if it mixes together, it still works great. So we're going to mix together our colors, and again, we're going to get the excess off. Always get the excess off before you go to the face, especially in blush. And we're just going to slightly start dusting. So you're going to see a little buildup, gradual buildup of color. Now, blush is what adds the color to the face, but it's not just necessarily for the cheekbone area. I like to use it to tie in all the color on the face. So I slightly go over the jawline, a little bit down the nose, into the hairline, over the earlobes. So it's really just tying in the overall look. You don't want to have any kind of stripes on your face at all. So after you've put your powder on, take your sponge and just soften any edges that you may have. Now, what we've done is we've contoured just a little bit underneath her bone, and that's what gives the illusion of the cheekbone. Now, what I like to do is take some of my lighter color and put it right on the apple of the cheeks. Now, if you're not sure where the apple of the cheeks are, we're just going to ask Lori to smile, and that's right where the color goes. And what it does is it just, this lighter color, blended in with the dark, really softens it, gives it a natural glow. Remember, a blush is really supposed to be just that, a natural blush to your face. It's important to know, too, that the look of blush right now is very minimal, very sparse, just very healthy. Now, you can also do a little bit of a light dusting right over your eye area, so close your eyes. And it's great. This is the softest brush. It just feels so good going over your face. It's designed to keep all the powder real loose so you're not going to have any big concentration of color on your face. Just blend. Now let's look before and after. Now let's go on to the next step. Now we're going to get into one of my favorite areas, how to do the lips, how to line the lips, and how to fill in with color. But first, I'm going to show you a great trick. Take my foundation, and here's my lip brush. Now use the handle. Go to your lighter color, and just go right up above the natural highlight line of your lip, and take a little bit of your foundation, and fill in with color. Now this is going to look kind of strange at first when you're doing that. But hang in there with me, because this works. Now you've drawn this little line above the lips, and then you're going to take your sponge and just blend. Now this makes a great little highlight that just adds to making a little bit of a sexier, poutier mouth. Now you're going to take a little bit of your darker color, and you're going to go underneath the lip. Now, sometimes I like to really accentuate this a little bit even more, and I use my darker brown pencil. But be sure, if you're going to get this brave, you really want that sexy mouth, that you're going to blend it in. Otherwise, you're just going to look like you have a dirty lip. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, make sure everything is nicely blended. And here we're going to start with our lip pencil. Now, what's so great about these lip pencils is not only do they really go well with your lipstick, but they're really soft and they're real easy to work with. Now, what I want to do is I just want to fill in natural, within her natural lip line, color. Now, what the pencil does is it defines the mouth, and it also serves as acting as a barrier so that the lipstick doesn't bleed, or what we call bleed or run, into your skin. Now, I'm using a real neutral tone here, and I'm just going to line around her lips. Now, open your mouth slightly, and make sure you go all the way to the corner. Now, if your line starts looking a little bit hard, just take your sponge and make sure you blend it through. Another really great trick after you've lined your lips is I like to use my pencil and just really fill the whole lip in with the color. Now, what this does, and you'll find that these pencils are so smooth, it's great to do that, but it really makes more of a stain for your lipstick. Now, these lipsticks are pretty great, and there's the amount of lipsticks that they stain anyway, but you're going to want to do this. You'll get a little longer lasting from them. Great. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to have some fun with using the lipsticks and mix and match the colors. Now, I'm using the peach kit and I'm using the pink kit. And I'm just going to blend. Now, you've got some great applicators that come in your compact. This sponge tip here is wonderful for the powder that's in the lip compact. And that's great for an evening look. You want to use this, though. It'll really help make it go on nice for you. And you got a wonderful lip brush, so this is going to be so convenient for you. Now, let's start putting on some color. I'm just blending some of the colors. And I'm just going to start filling in. Now, if you don't like a color that's coming up, or if it's coming up too dark or too light, mix it with something else. Take off your excess. And use your brush. This is the brush from your professional kit. It's wonderful. It'll really give you a nice lip line. Now, open your mouth. Now, what I'm going to do here is just fill in a little more color. Okay, now it's important when you're doing the lips that you do it working straight on, but also tilt your head up slightly so that you get another angle from underneath. Now, perfect lips are considered to be two very balanced lips, meaning top and bottom match. Now, very few of us have that. So what we're going to do here is Lori's mouth tends to just droop down a little bit at the end. I'm going to just work a little bit shy of the outer portion of her lip. I'm going to stop, and I'm going to give a little bit more of a lift up. Now, when you're working on the peaks, or the center of the lip, the bow of the mouth, you want to really round it out with your brush. Now, a problem a lot of women have is that they tend to just make very hard lines, and they really make a very strong, what we call bow to the mouth. And what it does is it ages you, so you want to keep it real soft. I'm just taking it and I'm slightly rounding it out. Now, all my lipsticks are very long-lasting in their staining. They're flat, they're more matte in their color, but they last a long time, they go on real smooth, and they're great for blending. Now, let's just go ahead and, for fun, add a little bit of the powder so you can really see what it does. We're going to take the applicator and use the powder and go right over. Now look at the wonderful highlight you get. Now again, just by doing this, you're going to even make the lips a little more longer lasting. And it changes it. It goes from a day look to an evening look very quickly. Okay. Now be sure to open your mouth. Make sure you've got all the inside of the corners, everything is connected. And if you need to, you can always go back and strengthen your lip line with your pencil if you're not happy with the way you filled in. But again, just make sure you're keeping it real natural. If you make any mistakes, always feel free to go back to your foundation and your sponge and clean it up. Now, I try to stay away from anything that's too glossy, because all of these are very creamy, but they're not glossy, because you don't want anything to run or bleed, like I said, into or around your mouth. And that's how we do lips. Now, let's look at Lori's before, and let's look at her after.
I can't believe it. That made such a difference. That was beautiful. Now what? What's next?
All right, well, first what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to go from a day look to an evening look really quickly. I think this is something a lot of women want to know. You know, you just,
right.
How quickly in 2 minutes or less can I take this day makeup and just look really great in the evening? So we're going to do that.
Do you do anything about hair?
Yes, we don't have to worry about your gorgeous hair, though. But yes, we do cover, for a lot of the ladies, we show through our before and afters some great hairstyles that will really help complement their makeups.
All right, that sounds good. I want you to tell me about your perfume. Now, I assume that one of these is your perfume. I smelled the sample yesterday. It smelled really beautiful.
Oh, I'm glad you loved it. We sent a little vial in all the kits because I thought this fragrance is so special. I wanted everyone to smell it. And of course,
it's
what
black.
Color? It comes in a black little bottle. That's great to put into your purse. And I just wanted something that would be really subtle and very intimate, something that you would have on and people would just want to get a little bit closer to
smell.
Right,
and that's something that as you walked by, the whole room knew what you were wearing.
Exactly.
Right.
You know, I don't like fragrances that they sort of walk in before you do. And this is just, you know, it's kind of your own personal statement. It's not mine.
Right.
And it's just, we were able to offer it, it's a perfume, and we're really able to offer it at a cologne price because we don't really have to deal with the middleman or retail markup, so we can give a great price.
Oh, that's wonderful. And when I tried it on last night, I mean yesterday, even last night, I could still smell it. It really lasted a long time.
Yeah.
It was beautiful. And it smelled different on each of the people in the room, too.
Yeah, that's kind of nice. It'll smell a little bit different on everybody, and it'll still be very subtle, and it lasts a long time.
And it will fit in my tiny little purse.
Yeah, what more can you ask for?
So now what are we doing?
Now we're going to show you a few tips on how to go from a day look to an evening look in just minutes.
Minutes?
Minutes.
Okay.
Now here's Laura. Let's talk about how we can go from a day look to an evening look in just minutes. Now the important thing when you start is you want to go from any kind of an oily residue or anything that you might have had on your face during the day and just take it off with a slight spray of your toning mist, which hopefully you've had in your purse. Now it's real light. You're going to use your sponge and just take down any shine that you may have. Now what's great is that the base is so light and it really stays where you put it in the morning that you shouldn't have too much shine. But it's nice and it's a good freshener. It'll just make your face feel a little bit better. Now if you are at home or you happen to have with you your eye makeup remover, what's great, since this is like water, is just take your remover, take a Q-tip, just dab a drop, just like water, and if you have any of your mascara underneath your eyes, any flakes or eyeshadow that's fallen, just dab underneath, take your Q-tip, and wipe it away. It's real fast. Sometimes what I do is I carry this, and I'll take a little bit of it, and I have a little bottle that I keep in my purse, real small, so that I can do real quick little touch-ups. Okay, now let's go into an evening look. But the thing is, you want to be able to do this very quickly. And all an evening look means is just a little more intensity. It's not a heavier makeup. That's important to remember. Now it's evening. Laura's going to go out, and she's going to have some fun. So why don't we work with some of the colors in my red kit? Now I'm going to use my eyeshadow, get the excess off, and I'm using a charcoal. So when you're using a darker color, you really want to make sure you get your excess powder off on your hand. Use your sponge, go to the outer portion of the eye, close your eyes, and let's just add some a little more intensity, a little smokier. Now I'm just going to do this one side so you can see the day look and the evening look, and you're going to see it's not a big dramatic difference. A lot of women tend to think they're going out for the evening, so they're going to put a lot more makeup on. You just want to just bring it up just a little bit, but no hard looks. Okay, now you can see that just using a little bit of the black, just a little bit, you can start to see it's really giving just a little bit more depth to her eyes, a little smokier, a little more evening. Again, get the excess off on your hand. You should be, you'll be a pro. You can keep this little compact in your desk at work, and in 2 seconds, you can do this look where you're into an evening look. Keep it in your purse. Okay, now put a little bit underneath your eyes. Open your eyes. Now what's going to help is we're going to use some black pencil. You can get a little more dramatic here. Okay, close your eyes. Let's line your eye. And all these things are something you can have thrown right in your purse. So wherever you are, you can sneak away into any bathroom and do this. Okay, now open your eyes and let's put just a little more black underneath the eyes. And again, just blend. Now look to me. Make sure you keep the concentration of your color on the outer portion of the eye. As you can see here, turn. I'm really keeping more of the color, the intensity of the color on the outer portion of the eye. Now, if you want to fill in a little bit with a little bit more of a fun color, in my red kit, I've got some great colors. You can experiment. Always remember, you can blend. All these colors are designed to blend together really nicely. So in the evening might be a time where you want to get a little more creative and do a little more blending of your colors and just have fun with it. Now I know I've talked about a lot about matte and staying away from iridescence, but it's okay at night to put a little bit of the iridescence powder on. I would just stay away from putting too much of it on during the day. And again, if you've got a problem or a real lined or wrinkled eye, you want to stay away from it as much as possible. Okay, open your eyes. Wait. And now we're gonna add just a little bit more black to the outer portion. And blend. Always blend and remember, the look of the wings on the outer portion of the eye is not in style anymore, as they say, or in vogue, so you really wanna keep current. Okay, open your eyes. Great. Now, if you need to, you can add just a little bit more mascara. One thing you should try to remember, though, is at the end of the day, you've put your mascara on. You don't want to go too heavy with your mascara application because then your eyelashes can just get really gloppy. So you might want to just lightly go over it with your black and then a little bit of the thickener from your gel. A very quick comb through, and you're set. Now let's take up your blush a little bit more. Now here I'm also working with the colors in my red kit. They're a little bit brighter, a little bit more fun. I love those colors. And we're gonna just intensify the cheeks just a little bit, maybe going over the eyes into the hairline. We're gonna just intensify her lips just a little bit. You've got your red pencil. Okay, fill in with color. Remember, when you're working with red, just keep it real soft, no hard lines. Okay, now let's fill in with some color. Now we're going to be working with the reds. Now in the red kit, here as you can see in my red lip kit, I've got a lot of different reds. I've got a red that's a little bit more red-blue, a little bit more red-orange. They're great to just blend together for a perfect red that you like. Okay, keep your mouth closed. Okay, open your mouth. Make sure you're getting into the corners of the mouth. Okay, close. Now let's start adding some of the powder. This is the fun part. For the evening, take the lip powder. Okay, keep your mouth closed all the way. Great. And this is what's going to help really give it the evening look. That little bit of iridescence. It's fun to just put a little bit of that iridescence right into the center of the lip. Adds a nice highlight, and it's a good evening effect. Okay, now, let's add a little bit more blush to this side. Now let's turn around and take a look. Let's take a look at the before. Now let's look at after.
That looked really easy. I mean, that was simple. I could do that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they're really easy techniques. So we're going to show you some great techniques right now, just to give you some variations on how your hair can help really complement your makeup.
Okay.
Great. Now, here's a woman, Laura. You may recognize her. We made her up earlier. Mm-hmm. And as you can see in her before picture, we've got her hair just a little more parted in the center. And just right. A good thing for someone to know is if you don't really want to draw attention to, say, your nose or something in the center of your face,
right.
You may want to change the where your part is located. So if you're going to move your part over here, then you're going to have more of the illusion isn't going to go to the center of your face, but it's going to go off center. That's a little trick. Now, what we did here, and Lori has a great nose, is in her after picture, is we just wanted to add a little more volume to her hair, because
right.
her hair was just straight and wanted to give it a little more body.
Right.
So we put in a wave and we did a little back combing, and it just increased the volume, which then just really set off her makeup even more. Now, Kathleen, here's a woman, her name is Celeste, and you look at her before, you can see she's got a real broad forehead.
Right.
Now, what we wanted to do in our hairstyling techniques, just to sort of distract a little from that broad forehead, was we created the look of some wispy bangs. They just go over her forehead very softly,
right.
and it just kind of breaks it up so you're not really looking at her forehead.
And you don't have to have them covered up entirely.
Right. Yeah, it's just soft enough to just, you know, so you're not going to look right at her forehead. You're just going to see a nice soft framing.
Right.
Now, she's also got a little bit of a long face.
Mm-hmm.
So what I've done is I've brought her hair around to frame her face. It also softens the look,
right.
adds more volume because she's got a thin face. So it just, as you can see, it just really adds the nice touch to her makeup.
Yeah.
Now, look at this woman, Kathleen.
Mm-hmm.
This is Yvonne. Now, she's got great hair. We haven't seen it yet, but she's got red hair. And I really like with the red hair, I think you can kind of go a little bit more, you
wild.
Know, a little bit more wild, but still keeping it soft. So what you can see we've done here is we've just really given her a little bit more fullness in her hair
right.
to her look, softened her features. They're a little bit angular. So what we did was we've just softened it with a soft wave to her hair and a nice soft bang that just kind of framed her face. And she looks real pretty.
The thing that's interesting, it's sort of the opposite of the other woman where you broke up the forehead more.
Right.
This, it's pulled, it frames her face, but it's pulled back more. And it
exactly.
brings the proportions of her whole face.
Exactly.
Into better proportion.
And it's a good thing to remember that if you have a very angular face, you just want to keep your hair, the wave, kind of really soft
mm-hmm.
so that you're not going to have any sort of real hard lines that are going to accentuate more of the angles on your face.
Right.
Now, here's a woman, Lael. She's got a great face.
Mm-hmm.
And again, I think I talked about angular faces. She's really got great bone structure. So I wanted to do just something with the hair that creates a really nice sort of upsweep.
Right.
And just really, you see her cheekbones, you get a great line that you're going to see from her blush.
Mm-hmm.
Her face just really jumps out at you, and her hair is just real soft, and a nice updo will help really do that for you. Now, Kathleen, here's a young woman who a lot of times women think they've got very straight hair, and
mm-hmm.
it's just kind of hanging there. What can I do with it? And she was talking to me about getting a body wave and perms and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
And I told her, you know, she could just do some great things with just a real easy set
right.
and putting in some nice soft waves. And you can tell by our after picture here that we just gave her hair a little bit more body. We set her hair.
Mm-hmm.
And it just looks prettier. It's amazing if you just do a nice, simple set, what it will do. Well, now here's Shirla. This is one of my favorite makeovers. As you can see before, she had a few lines in her face. We really wanted to keep her look soft. Mm-hmm. So in her after here,
she doesn't look like the same person.
Well, we've really given her some nice softening looks in her makeup, but we've also complemented that with her hair. And we've used a curling iron to just put in some real soft little waves mm-hmm. and give some height to her face
right.
and a little bit of bangs to cut down her forehead a little bit. Right. But very soft and just create a real nice frame for the makeup. Now here's Carrie. Now mm-hmm. this is again one of my favorite makeovers, and what we did was we tried to really make it a very soft, a little more contemporary look,
yes.
as you can see here.
Yes.
Just something that really brought out her facial structures, and we sort of have this bob look by her cheekbone. It brings out her cheekbones, you see her jawline, and she just looks beautiful. Now here's Carla. If you look at her before, we've just got her hair pulled back, and she
right.
tends to wear it that way a lot. And I really wanted to, again, here, using the technique of blow drying her hair,
mm-hmm.
I wanted to just really soften her look, create a light bang that would go over her forehead,
right.
and really create some volume that you would just see this wonderful head of hair. And it just looks beautiful.
20 years ago, I had really long hair, so I didn't learn any hair techniques. And it was the 70s, so I didn't wear any makeup either, and I really wish I had learned back then in high school how to do all this.
Well, that's what's so great about the section that we do now on for teens, because, you know, a lot of teens want to wear makeup, but they just tend to sort of, like, pile on the makeup.
And they're the ones that don't need it, usually.
I know. So we sort of really start them out right and teach them the right way to do the makeup.
Great.
Now, here's Deanna. She came in today, well, I think with just a little bit too much makeup on. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna have her take her makeup off. We're gonna start with nothing, and I'm gonna teach her some great techniques for a better look. So let's get started. Now, Deanna's just come back, and as you can see, she's got no makeup on and beautiful skin. So I'm gonna do a real minimal application in my makeup. But first, I'm gonna use my toning mist. I'll give her a light spray. And we're gonna go right to foundation. And what I like to do when I'm doing the foundation, especially on somebody who's got a young skin, really beautiful skin like this, is really just spot apply where needed. So I'm just gonna make sure to even out her face, blending it right into the color again, as this is the medium skin tone, the medium kit, and it's blending right into her own color. And you really almost, you don't really want to even know that you've got this makeup on. And the mistake most teens tend to make is that they go just a little bit too heavy in their application. Now we're going to make sure we cover all the areas that have any kind of redness. We're going to go a little bit underneath the eyes. And I know this is a great way for you to start once you're starting with using your sponges. It's a good way to get used to start doing your makeup because you're gonna love the effects you can get. Now we're almost done in our application. And again, if you need to use a little more coverage under the eyes, that's fine. But I really want to illustrate, look at how much is on my sponge, very little foundation. This is important. This product, a little bit, goes a long way. Okay. Now, if I were to use this much heavier, it would change the whole look. And I really just want to keep it very sheer and very natural. Again, if you're doing it right, you shouldn't have to go too far down on the neck. It'll blend right into your skin tone. Your friends aren't even going to know you have this on. And if you've got a blemish or something that you need to cover, this is gonna do it. Okay. Now, once you've done that, if you feel you need to take down any of the foundation at all, if you've gotten a little too heavy, take your toning mist. And it's real easy to take away any foundation. It's also a nice way to set your makeup so it'll make it last longer. Now, let's go on to the powder. We're gonna use our translucent powder. It's a very fine powder. You need very little. Just go over your foundation. Great. great. You can see how quickly we're moving. Very little product. Okay, now something that usually all teens could start to learn to do a little work on is their eyebrows. So for that, we're going to work with our taupe pencil, and we're going to just start filling in just ever so lightly. Remember, this is something you're going to practice, you're going to be able to do, just to give a little bit more of a framing around your eyes. And be sure you blend it. Now, the taupe color is good, especially for teens, because it's real natural and it's real soft. So it's almost like a skin tone color, very compatible to your own skin. If you went with something either too dark of a brown or even black, it just wouldn't look natural. Now, you can see here with Deanne, I'm using very little. You can see that? And already it's starting to frame her eye. Great, now let's do the other side. And we're just blending it. And what I've done is I've added a little more length to her eyebrow. Again, the way to know exactly how to begin and end is take your eyebrow pencil, hold it in the corner of your eye, and go straight up from the corner of your eye with an imaginary line. This is where your brow should begin. Now, when you take your pencil and go exactly to the diagonal, the outer portion of the eye, this is where it should end. Now, don't do too much tweezing. A lot of teens I know are kind of real happy with those tweezers, and they just tend to take too much out and do it right before you're making up. Don't do that because it'll irritate your skin, and it'll make the makeup and the pencil grab unevenly. Okay, now we're gonna go to our gel, and this is great. I think if any one product I really had to say is great for the teens, this is great because it's wonderful for the brows, and at the same time, just to show you how quickly, we're gonna go right over the lashes, which is helping to thicken the lashes, and you could use this without any mascara. So say you can't kind of con your mom into letting you use that black mascara just yet. Well, at least you can use this side. Great. Now for a little bit more color on the eyebrows, if you want to add just a touch more, if you've got some of your brown eyeshadow in your very light shade, since you've just used some of your gel, you can apply over. Great. Now, if you start to see shine, go back to your powder and just slightly blend. Now, remember, I want to keep it real natural so we still see the natural color of your skin coming through. Now, let's line your eyes. Using your pencil, close your eyes and use your pencil right down in the lash line, very sparingly though, just enough to give the effect of thickening your lashes. Be sure to blend. Now, I can't stress this enough, especially with your teenagers. You're getting a good head start here. So what you need to do is really always remember to just apply your product and blend it right out. And it'll look real soft, and it's still gonna give you the effect you want. Now, open your eyes, and let's just use a little bit of color underneath the eye, stippling, dotting in between the lashes. Now, if you see, just with this little bit of color, it's really making a difference. It's still very subtle. Okay, now let's do the other eye. Close your eyes. And blend. Now, don't worry if your line gets a little bit too thick and you're not quite in that lash line. That takes practice. And you can always blend it right out. Close your eyes. Now, dot right into the lashes again on the bottom. Great. Now, let's go on to using some mascara. If we're going to use a little bit of the black, if your mom's let you use the black, just take a little bit, real slight, lightly underneath, just to give a little bit of a color. You don't need to do too much building, just real soft. just so you're tinting your lashes a little bit. Great. Now, you're just about ready for your blush. You want to keep it real soft, real natural, and as though it's really just a natural blush. And at this age, you still want to keep that natural, innocent look, so why not play it up? We're just going to go a little bit, feel down the side of your face. You're not sure where to put your blush, feel down the side of your face, feel the bone. If you're still not sure, suck in your cheeks, and you're going to see the hollow. Where the hollow is, that's where you're going to apply your darker color. Now have fun mixing your shades, which with each blush, you get a light and a dark color. So let's just use a little bit of that darker in the hollow. Okay. You're gonna go on the cheekbone, the jawline, and in the hair. Now we haven't done any eyeshadow yet, but here's a quick little tip. You can take your blush, close your eyes, and very quickly, you don't even have time in the morning to do your eyeshadow. Just use your blush. Go right over your eyes. Blend it out. And you can have some fun color right there. Okay, now let's go on to lining your lips. Use a neutral color and try to stay right within your natural lip line. Now use your pencil to fill in with color. And this is great. So at this point, you haven't even used your lipstick. And if you were running out the door, you'd still look great right now. But let's add a little bit more lipstick just for fun. Now, if you need to blend your pencil, that's fine. You just go right ahead and use your sponge. Now, I'm going to be working here with my pink kit. And I'm going to take my brush. And I'm going to just very lightly give her some nice color. Just a little bit of color. Just to complement the pencil and the stain on the lips. Remember, we're going for a real sort of stained look. You're depositing color on the face without all the texture. That's important to remember. Now, if you'd like, what's fun to do is take a little bit of the powder using your applicator and take just a little bit and put it on the center of the lower lip. Great. Looks real natural. Now to finish off, let's just take our powder. Any shine you see, go right over the area. And don't hesitate if you missed an area that needs a little more foundation or blush, you can go right back for it. Now here's a little trick I'm gonna do because I'm looking at Deanna, and those of you, you may wanna do this if you've got a little bit of a cleft chin, which I see Deanna does. I see a little indentation. Sometimes it's really nice to play up a feature that maybe you think, well, I don't know if that's one of my better features, but it makes you just a little bit different. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my pencil and I'm just going to slightly, right in the center, just create a little shadow. It's just, it's a little bit interesting and it's a little bit unique to Deanna's face. Real subtle. Now make sure you do it subtle. You don't want to look like Kirk Douglas. Okay, and that's her finished look. Now let's take a look at Deanna before. Now let's look at her after. What a difference. Now here's what we did earlier with this teen. Look at her before, now look at her after. Just a simple application of makeup and she looks great. Now those of you that have a teenager at home, take a look at what we did with this teen. Here you see her before, and you can see she's got a severe case of acne and she's really insecure about it. Now take a look at what we did after. Using the base, we really evened out her skin. We added a little more eye makeup and lip color, and she just was thrilled at how she looked.
So where were you when I was in high school?
I was in high school, only I had orange hair and I painted rainbows on my eyes.
Rainbows?
Well, I was a makeup artist, you know. Anyway, right now we're ready to look at how to deal with specific problem areas.
Like rainbows?
Like rainbows. Now here's Brigitte. What we're gonna do is we're gonna talk about contouring, doing your cheeks, how to do your blush, how to work a little bit on your jawline, and then we're gonna go into lips. So let's start with working with our blush brush. This is what you got in your kit, your professional brush kit. And here we're gonna work with our peach color. We're gonna work with our peach, and I'm gonna mix a little bit with our pink and our red kits, the blush as well, because it's kind of fun to do that. Now what you do is you mix your colors, get some of the powder obviously on the brush, dust off the excess. Now I want you to feel down the side of the face. Now where you feel the bone, right below in that hollow is where you're gonna apply your blush. Now a little bit of your darker, of your concentration of color, you can work with the darker color in your blush. That's why you have a lighter and a darker. It's gonna go right in that hollow. That's what's gonna actually contour, recess, or shade the area. And you really just wanna work back and forth in a very fluid movement so that you're really making it very smooth. And if you need to, you can take your sponge and you can even out any powder. Now, because you're using your blush in a way where you're getting your powder off, you're controlling how much is actually going to the face. Now, again, it's real easy. A lot of people have a hard time saying, well, where exactly does the blush go? And if you follow this feeling down the side of your face into that hollow or sucking in your cheeks, if you want to suck in your cheeks a little bit, you can almost see right where a natural shadow is going to fall. It's in that hollow. Now we're going to do the other side. And blush should really just be exactly that, a light blush, a dusting of color, very soft, very subtle. Now what you need to be careful of is that you don't get too close to the nose. Just enough that you're right below the bone so that you're getting the contour, not all the way to the center of the face. That's where we're going to use our lighter color just to warm up and blend your darker shade. Now when you're doing your blush, you also want to do some contouring with your blush on the jawline. Again, making sure you're getting all the powder off, going over the jawline. Again, we're going to go over the eyes, close your eyes, do a light dusting over the eyes. This really ties in the color all over the face and into the hairline. Now, let's take a little bit of our lighter shade. And here we're working in our pink kit, and we're using the lighter color. We're dabbing it on, getting the excess, and just smile, and it's right here on the apple of the cheeks is where you want your lighter blush to go. And what it does is it's really just evening out and blending right into the darker shading color. Now make sure you don't go too high up on your blush. You need to have it right below this bone, and that's what's gonna give you the contour. And make sure you take your sponge and you blend. And that's how you do your blush. Remember, you just want to deposit the color on the face without all the texture. Now let's go on to the lips. Now Brigitte has thin lips, so what we're going to do is we're going to make her lips a little bit fuller. And I'm going to start by lining the lips with the pencil. Now at this point on the lower lip, since the top lip is a little bit thinner, I'm going to go over the top line on the top of the lips. I'm going to slightly go above her natural lip line to give the look of a little bit of a larger lip. Now you have to be really careful when you do this and build it up into steps. You don't want to do something that's going to be really unnatural. So what you really have to do is in your mind's eye, you have to envision two perfectly balanced lips, and that's what we're trying to create. Now we're working in our peach lip pencil here. It's very soft, it's easy to blend, it's very natural. Now remember, if your lips are thin, You want to work with colors that are going to be light in color. Same with your pencil. Because if you use anything that's too dark, it's actually going to make your lips look smaller. So here I am going slightly above her natural lip line. And now I'm going to do some filling in with color. Now what we're going to do, and a good trick, is to go slightly darker on the lip that's a little bit fuller. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to go a little bit darker. And then on the upper lip, we're going to go a little bit lighter. And this is going to help really balance the lips so that they're going to look like they're the same size. Now, as you can tell, we've really gone over Bridget's natural lip line, but we needed to do that to balance out the lips. Now here I'm using my lip powder, which is giving that lightening effect to the top of the lip. Now what I'm going to do is go back to my pencil, and I'm going to just go slightly over the lip line again to even out the bottom of the lip, making sure to blend. The whole key to doing lips, and it really takes some practice and it takes some patience, is to make sure that you do it naturally. Just build it up gradually. Don't, if you've got thin lips, don't try to do lips that are going to be three times your normal size, because no matter how good you do it, it's probably going to not be too believable. Great. Now that's lips. Now you've just seen Brigitte go from thin lips to full lips. Now let me show you something else you've received in your kit. These great reminder cards. Now there's over 40 cards here that illustrate every problem or flaw you can think of. At least everyone that I could think of. And there's 40, so I think we cover just about everything. And what's so great about these cards is not only do they go in great detail in their illustrations, but in the copy and telling you just how to correct any problem or flaw you could have. Everything from eyes to cheeks to lips. So you've seen a lot in this tape, but everything you could possibly need to know is in these cards. In this card is one special card that tells you about the major mistakes most women make in their eye application. Let's talk about the first common mistake most women make when they're doing their eyes. They use too much iridescent eyeshadow. And that will really just attract more attention to wrinkled or lined areas. So it's okay to use for evening, but be careful that you don't use it too heavily. Okay, now the second biggest common mistake is the eyebrows, neglecting to work on the eyebrows. As you can see in all the makeovers we've done by putting the taupe pencil and the powders, it really helps when you work on the eyebrows because the eyebrows frame the eye, so don't neglect them. Now let's talk about another problem. Most women want to have big eyes, and what they do is they tend to line the inside or the rim of the eye with dark color. And what that does is close up the eye. So make sure that you don't do this, because if you put the dark color in there, you're going to make your eyes look smaller. And another common mistake is most women, when they're choosing their eyeshadow, they try to match their eye color and their eyeshadow color. An example. A woman with blue eyes tries to wear blue eyeshadow, and all you see is the blue eyeshadow, not the beautiful blue eyes. Now, if you were to go ahead and use a real smoky color to your eyes, a real charcoal muted brown or something like that, you would have a great look to those blue eyes. Now, the last major mistake most women make was how they do their eyeshadow application. They start from the inner portion of the eye, and they work out. We've always shown you that you work from the outer portion of the eye in toward the nose. This is what actually redefines the eye, and you're not following the natural droop or contour of the eye. Now, these are all common mistakes that women make. We've all made them. I've made them as well. And these are some good tips that if you follow, I think you're going to like the way your eyes look a lot better. Now here's Tina, and we're going to cover contouring. Now you're going to need, those of you that have a light foundation kit might need a medium. Those of you using medium kits are going to need tan, and tan, possibly you might need a dark. Now because Tina falls into between a tan and a dark foundation kit, we're going to be doing some contouring in our dark kit. So let's get started. Now I'm going to be working with a brush. You at home might want to use a sponge or a Q-tip, and that's fine, whatever works for you. Now, when we do contouring, we want it to be real natural. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start to shade her nose a little bit. I'm using the darker color in my darkest kit. I'm going to get the excess off my brush, and I'm going to start slightly shading her nose. Now remember, contouring is like sculpting. Now turn. And what I want to do is just thin her nose just a little. I'm going down the sides of her nose and right up into her eyebrow. Now, once you've gotten your color on, make sure you go to your sponge and blend. This is very important. This is the key to good shading and contouring. Now, I find it easiest to work with a brush. You may like working with a Q-tip or, as I said earlier, with a sponge. Whatever works. Just make sure that it's natural. Now let's lightly powder. Now you can see with just a little bit of subtle contouring what a difference it's made for Tina's nose. Now another tip would be if you had a long nose, you could just slightly shadow below the nose, and that would help give the illusion of a shorter nose. Now you've got your reminder cards, and there's a lot of great tips in there for contouring. Now here's Dawn. What I want to do is I want to show you some techniques for under-eye dark circles, a little bit of a puff, and then we're going to do some shadowing on how to deal with a fold that slightly goes over on your upper lid. We're going to make it real simple. Okay, first we're going to start with our foundation again. Here we go. Now we're going to blend our colors. And a mistake that women commonly make if there's any kind of an under-eye puff or bag is they go too light in their color and in their application, which really just accentuates the problem. Now she has no other makeup on, and I wanted her to sit here with nothing else on so that you could really see the difference. Okay, now slightly turn to me. Now if you need to, you can use this stippling technique we talked about before, where you're just patting over the area. And make sure you blend it into the rest of your foundation or your skin tone. Now we're going to use some powder to set. Now this is important, just use a light dusting. And remember, if you have a lot of lines around the eyes, you don't want to use too much powder. So I'm just using very little, as you can see here on my puff. I'm pressing it into the puff so it's not going to just be sitting on her skin. And I'm just taking away some of that shine. Okay. Now let's talk a little bit about lining your eyes. If you have a puff or a bag underneath the eye, what you want to do is instead of working where we talked about earlier, higher up in the lash line, you want to go slightly lower down. What this does is it creates the illusion of actually cutting the puff in two. Now here's what I mean. Normally we might be working up here, but here on Dawn we're going to work just a little bit lower. Now I'm using my pencil to just reduce that puff. Be sure to apply it and then blend it out. Now close your eyes, and we're going to do it again on the top, just going down into the lash line, which we've shown you before, just to thicken the lashes. And we're going to blend. Now open your eyes. Now what's important here, when you see any kind of a fold over the eye, Normally, a mistake a lot of women make is they tend to make up with eyeshadow with their eyes closed, and they never get the placement quite right. So if we had Dawn closing her eyes, close your eyes, and she just was doing her makeup herself and she just worked like this, chances are when she opened her eyes, she wouldn't quite have the makeup where it needed to be. So the best thing to do is work with your eye open, keep your eye open. Use your slant tip at the outer portion of the eye. Now here again, I'm using my peach kit, using my very soft browns. I'm just doing some defining at the outer portion of the eye, but I'm actually going right over the fold of the eye, so it's actually reducing it. Now, when you work this way, where I'm reducing it, the fold from the top, and I've used my pencil where I've moved it down a little bit on the puff underneath, this is what's going to give the illusion of giving a little bit more depth to an eye where there's a little bit of a fold already. And the whole key here is really in having the eye open when you're doing your application. And once you have your application established, and again, here we are working at the outer portion of the eye in toward the nose, keeping the concentration of color on the outer portion. Close your eyes. You can use your fill-in side for your color, working lighter in toward the nose. Great, now open your eyes. And again, if a little bit more is needed, just go right over that fold. And that really helps to reduce it. And then be sure to blend. Make sure you really blend at the outer portion. Now, something else to remember here. All of these eyeshadows are very flat in their colors. They're matte. There's no shine. You don't want anything that's too iridescent. If you have a problem with an eye area in terms of like a droopy eye or a fold of skin, you don't want to use an iridescence because it's just going to draw more attention to that area. So you want to keep it very flat, and that's what I'm doing here. Now, let's just put on a little bit of mascara. Again, it's easiest when you have your eye open for your application. Now, these are real subtle techniques, but they're very effective when you're trying to correct a specific problem. I'm going to very quickly just fill in her brows. Seems I can never just work on one section of an eye. When I see this in another area, I could slightly touch up. We're just going to fill in just a bit. Then let's go over with some powder. Now let's take a look. This is before. Now this is after. Now take a look at this woman, Carrie. As you can see, she really has dark under eye circles. Now what you need to do to take care of this problem is you need to go one shade lighter in your foundation, or a half a shade lighter possibly, than the under eye dark circle, and be sure to blend thoroughly with your sponge. This should take care of all your problems. Now let's meet Shirla. Now we're going to talk about minimizing facial lines and wrinkles and how to give you a good head start and not having to put on a little bit too much makeup that's going to really accentuate some of those problems. So let's start with our moisturizer. We take just a little bit of moisturizer, and it's important. I want you to see I'm really just dabbing very little. I'm going to get the excess off on my hand, and I'm just going to very lightly apply in a downward motion over her face with the moisturizer. Now this is absorbed very quickly into the skin, and what it's going to do is create a really nice smooth base for my foundation to go over. Because when you're wanting to minimize lines and wrinkles, you want to use a little bit less makeup. Otherwise, you can almost draw more attention to the problem area. So just a little bit goes a long way. It's absorbed right into the skin. And Shirla's probably feeling right now, this stuff feels great because I don't even know I have it on. Okay. Now, something else that's kind of nice to do a little bit on an older skin is to take some of the eye gel repair and take a little bit on your finger and just stipple in toward the nose, just dotting very lightly. And this helps reduce any kind of bags, puffs. And it's great if you wake up in the morning and your eyes are just a little bit puffy. This is going to help take that down. It's a really, really light gel. You're not even going to be able to see that you have it on, and your makeup goes over it great. Okay. Now, let's go over with our toning mist to keep your face feeling really fresh. And now we're ready to put on the foundation. Okay. Now, Shirla has a medium skin tone, so I'm going to be working in the medium kit. And I just want to even out her skin tone. You don't want to add too much, but still give you some of the coverage. Now, when you see any kind of discoloration on the skin, or this goes with freckles as well, you just want to even out the skin tone. Don't feel you need to put down a real heavy base to cover everything on the face. It's kind of nice to have some of the freckles come through. It shows a little bit more of your natural skin. And a mistake that older women commonly make is they just try to cover too much and they apply too heavily, and instead you're drawing more attention. So we're going to be using this half face technique again so that you're going to be able to see the difference. Now here you can see Shirla has short hair, so we want to go right into her hairline and going over the earlobes. And again, these colors are so perfectly blended. The skin tone, it blends right into her skin, so you shouldn't have to go too far down on the neck, so you don't have to worry about ruining any of those pretty white blouses. Okay, now let's work right up in the eye area to cover up any of the under eye dark, any kind of puffiness. And you're working in toward the nose, just slightly stippling, just patting in the area. Remember, look and see here, you can see a very little foundation. A little bit's gonna go a long way. And when you're applying, you can apply with the makeup, and then when you need to blend out, use a clean side. You can slightly go over the eyelid, close your eyes. And this will take away from any blue or discoloration that you have above the eyes, if you wanna just lighten them up. And this will help open the eye up as well. Okay, now open your eye. Great. And don't be afraid to get the sponge right up to that lash line underneath the eye. And go all around toward the nose. Now let's powder. Now again, when you're using your powder, and this is really important to remember when you're minimizing facial lines and wrinkles, the biggest mistake you can make is use too much powder and it will just really draw more attention. So very lightly, and this is again why I use a puff, because I take the powder, I press it right into the puff, I get the excess off on my hand, and then I just go to the face. So I'm just really dusting over my foundation and I'm taking away any shine. Now you can tell the makeup's gone over fine. We had on moisturizer, we had eye gel, and it's still, there's no trace. That's what's so great about the products. They're not greasy. Now, if we had something real greasy, a heavy night cream or something around the eyes, you wouldn't be able to get this flat, matte look. Okay. Now we've prepared her face. We've evened out her skin tone. Let's just do a little work with the eyebrows. Using the taupe pencil, and this is another very important thing to remember. A woman, when you're getting a little older, sometimes you can tend to, when you're working on your eyebrows, using the arch, which is the midpoint of the eyebrow, really create too high of an arch. You need to really round it off and keep it very smooth. And always be sure to blend. Okay, now let's go over some of that with the eyebrow gel.
And we're going to go over with a little bit of powder. Just brush, keep it very soft. As you can see for Shirla's coloring here, I'm working in the taupes, very light browns. I don't want anything that's gonna look hard. Okay, now let's start defining her eyes a little bit. We're gonna use a dark brown pencil. Close your eyes. Now remember, when the face has a little bit of a more lines or wrinkles, you're going to have to hold the eye with a little more pressure. Hold it taut. Don't be afraid to hold some of those lines and just pull them out a little bit, because you really need to get the pencil down right into some of those problem areas. Always apply and then just blend it right out. Now, I'm sure by now you can see that I use very little product, and I'm always blending it right away. So you want to just always remember to apply and blend. It's real important. Okay, now open your eyes. Now we're going to do a little bit of work underneath the eye. Okay. You look straight ahead. Remember, when you're doing your own eyes, and everybody's gonna have a way that's different when they're doing their own eyes and where it is that it's comfortable for you to look. Some people like feel very comfortable looking straight up, straight across, wherever it's really comfortable for you. And it's always easiest when you're working with pencils to work off to the side as opposed to straight on. You'll find that you won't blink as much. Okay, now I'm making this very smoky, and I'm just blending. Now let's move on to our eyeshadow. Now this is another really important part. When you're working with an eye that has any kind of a fold or a droop or a puffy eye or lines around the eyes, it's very important that you stay away from anything that's too iridescent. You really need to work in very flat, matte colors. So what you want to do, we're working with our slant tip. You're working your flat, matte brown, and we're gonna start getting the excess off on our hand. And we're gonna work at the outer portion. Now, as you can see, some dustings fell. A good tip for you to prevent that happening is you can work this way, holding a Kleenex so that when any kind of powder falls, it'll fall right onto the Kleenex. Or if you're having a little bit of difficulty in creating this shaping, which I'm gonna talk about now, which is your V shaping right here on the eye, take the corner of your sponge, hold it up to the corner of the eye, and work from the outer portion of the eye in toward the nose. Now this is real important, especially on an eye where the eye is tending to droop down. We all get a little older and the eye starts going downward. If you start here and just keep working outward, you're never going to change that. But if you start here and work in, you're going to correct the problem. You'll also notice I'm getting the powder right here on my sponge as opposed to on her face. Now, what Shirla's doing, and this is important to remember to do when you're doing your makeup, especially if there's any kind of a fold, you need to look in the mirror and keep your eye open and place it in the area that needs it the most, as opposed to closing your eyes. Close your eyes, Shirla. If Shirla kept her eyes closed all the time and just did her makeup this way, which a lot of women tend to do, and then opened and it wasn't quite where she needed it, it's good to look straight in the mirror, have your eyes open, and place the makeup where it's going to be needed most. Remember, always soften out the outer portion, keeping it real soft. Now I'm keeping my darker color on the outer portion of the eye, and then I'm going to use my lighter shade, dusting off the excess in the center. Close your eyes. The reason for that is we're just blending. We want to keep it so that there's an evenness. You don't really see where one color ends and the other begins. It's important, especially for an older woman, that you don't have a real light color, a dark color, another color. I mean, that's very dated. You just want very soft colors that blend one into the other. Okay, well, let's add a little more liner. Close your eyes. Great. Now I'm going to add just a little more to the eyebrow. Look straight up. Now also, something else to really be careful of is make sure, so we want to keep the eye open. We don't want to draw any unnatural attention, especially for you older women. Don't put any of the dark color on the inside rim of the eye. Put it down lower in the lash line. And what's especially effective is if you do have some slight puff or bag underneath the eye, what you want to do is, instead of working too high up in the lash line, move a little bit lower down to reduce that puff. And you'll see that it actually will cut the puff in half. Now let's go on to mascara. I'm going to just lightly curl her lashes. Some of you will like to do that. I think Shirley's going to panic a little here. It's really a great tool if you just use a little pressure on the tips to help curl, to help open up the eyes. Now let's use our black mascara. And let's even thicken those lashes a little bit. That's what this is so great for, not only for the eyebrows, but for the lashes, to thicken them. Again, it's real important. You don't want to do too much in terms of your mascara, drawing unnatural attention to your eyes. A good rule to remember is, if you have a problem area to the face, don't draw the attention to the problem area. Okay, now what we do is to comb through the lashes. I'm gonna again wrap the Kleenex around my finger, take my comb, and go right through the lashes. This gets the excess off. What's great too is, sometimes as we get older, our lashes tend to fall out. So that's what's so great about having this gel, because it will also thicken those lashes. So you'll have a little bit nicer coverage with your mascara. Well, let's talk about blush. We really just want to do a light dusting of blush, real soft. As you can see, I'm using my peach tones. And I'm just blending the colors together, getting the excess off on my hand. And I'm just going to go over her face, her jawline, her blush line, into her hairline, down the nose, a little bit even over her eyes. And the blush is just going to even everything out. It's great. You don't want to use too much powder, though, just enough to give the little bit of some color without all the texture of the powder. Okay, now let's go on to lips. Now, what's also great about this eye gel repair is, it's not just for eyes, it's for fine dry lines around the eyes, but also around the mouth. So, take a little bit again on your finger, and use very little, and just go right around the mouth and blend it in. This really helps any fine dry lines. Just makes the lip pencil go on smoother and your lipstick. Okay, now you can take your sponge, blend it in. Now let's line our lips. Okay, you really want to go with a very soft, neutral color. Keep your mouth closed. Stay within the natural lip line. And especially if there's lines around the mouth, you want to be very careful to not go with any kind of dark line, because that would just, again, draw more attention to the problem area. So you can... Now fill in with color. Okay, turn toward me. And when you're doing your lips, you need to look at it from different angles. Straight on, tilt the head up just a little bit to make sure you're getting a straight lip line underneath. Just open your mouth a little bit and make sure you're getting into the corners of the mouth. Okay, now close your mouth. Always when you're doing your lips and you're ending, keep your mouth closed, because believe it or not, it's very different. The lip line's very different with the mouth closed as it is when it's slightly parted or open. Now this may look kind of strange, seeing Shirla sitting here with just half of her face done, but when I turn her around and you see half, I want you to really see the difference. Then maybe what we'll do is we'll let Shirley make up the other half of her face, and we can see how beautiful she looks. Now here I've filled in just with my pencil, and I'm gonna go over it with my lipstick. Now this is important when you're using your lipstick. Again, these colors are wonderful because they're all very flat and matte. You wanna keep it real neutral, very light. Okay, close your mouth. Now this is one case where I love my powder lips, but if you've got a lot of fine lines and dry lines, fine lines around the mouth, stay away from the iridescence around the mouth. And after you've applied your lipstick, if you need to go back and just apply a little bit more of your pencil. That's fine. Okay, now we're gonna just finish off with just another real light dusting of some powder. Give a little bit more color, some blush. Now let's take a look at before and after. Here, let's take a look all the way before. Now let's look after. I think she looks great.
Well, Kathleen, we're just about out of time. You know, we've covered a lot of ground, and we've covered all the basic techniques you need and a lot of the individual problems that many of us have to deal with. Now, you'll find there are several problem areas that we didn't demonstrate that are covered in your reminder cards. Now, those cards use techniques that we've covered in this tape and are pretty much self-explanatory. Like I mentioned in the beginning, if some of these techniques seem a little slower or harder than what you're used to doing, don't panic. You've been practicing your way for years. It'll only take a few weeks of practice, and these techniques will result in both a better and faster application of makeup. Most important, don't be afraid to experiment. It's only makeup. It washes right off, and just have fun.
Watching Victoria's techniques and using her makeup should tell you that she probably knows more about what works best with a woman's face than any other cosmetic company president in America. But more important than all of this is a side of Victoria that I wish you could see. She's someone who really, really cares, which makes her such a good friend. And she cares about what goes into her products and onto your face, because it's going onto her face too. She cares about how well they work and what women have to spend to buy her products. And I like that she cares about animals to not use them for product testing. With her products, you'll always have the confidence of knowing you're getting something that's been developed by a woman who spent her whole life helping others to look more naturally beautiful, a woman who really cares. Thank you for joining us. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks, Victoria.
Thank you, Kathleen.
Great. Now that's lips. Now you've just seen Brigitte go from thin lips to full lips. Now let me show you something else you've received in your kit. These great reminder cards. Now there's over 40 cards here that illustrate every problem or flaw you can think of, at least everyone that I could think of. And there's 40, so I think we cover just about everything. And what's so great about these cards is not only do they go in great detail in their illustrations, but in the copy and telling you just how to correct any problem or flaw you could have. Everything from eyes to cheeks to lips. So you've seen a lot in this tape, but everything you could possibly need to know is in these cards. In this card is one special card that tells you about the major mistakes most women make in their eye application. Let's talk about the first common mistake most women make when they're doing their eyes. They use too much iridescent eyeshadow, and that will really just attract more attention to wrinkled or lined areas. So it's okay to use for evening, but be careful that you don't use it too heavily. Okay, now the second biggest common mistake is the eyebrows, neglecting to work on the eyebrows. As you can see in all the makeovers we've done by putting the taupe pencil and the powders, it really helps when you work on the eyebrows because the eyebrows frame the eye, so don't neglect them. Now let's talk about another problem
Most women want to have big eyes, and what they do is they tend to line the inside or the rim of the eye with dark color. And what that does is close up the eye. So make sure that you don't do this, because if you put the dark color in there, you're going to make your eyes look smaller. And another common mistake is most women, when they're choosing their eyeshadow, they try to match their eye color and their eyeshadow color. An example, a woman with blue eyes tries to wear blue eyeshadow, and all you see is the blue eyeshadow, not the beautiful blue eyes. Now, if you were to go ahead and use a real smoky color to your eyes, a real charcoal muted brown or something like that, you would have a great look to those blue eyes. Now, the last major mistake most women make was how they do their eyeshadow application. They start from the inner portion of the eye and they work out. We've always shown you that you work from the outer portion of the eye in toward the nose. This is what actually redefines the eye, and you're not following the natural droop or contour of the eye. Now, these are all common mistakes that women make. We've all made them. I've made them as well. And these are some good tips that if you follow, I think you're going to like the way your eyes look a lot better. Now, here's Tina, and we're going to cover contouring. Now, you're going to need, those of you that have a light foundation kit might need a medium. Those of you using medium kits are going to need tan, and tan, possibly you might need a dark. Now, because Tina falls into between a tan and a dark foundation kit, we're going to be doing some contouring in our dark kit. So let's get started. Now, I'm going to be working with a brush. You at home might want to use a sponge or a Q-tip, and that's fine, whatever works for you. Now, when we do contouring, we want it to be real natural. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start to shade her nose a little bit. I'm using the darker color in my darkest kit. I'm going to get the excess off my brush, and I'm going to start slightly shading her nose. Now remember, contouring is like sculpting. Now turn. And what I want to do is just thin her nose just a little. I'm going down the sides of her nose and right up into her eyebrow. Now, once you've gotten your color on, make sure you go to your sponge and blend. This is very important. This is the key to good shading and contouring. Now, I find it easiest to work with a brush. You may like working with a Q-tip or, as I said earlier, with a sponge. Whatever works. Just make sure that it's natural. Now let's lightly powder. Now you can see with just a little bit of subtle contouring what a difference it's made for Tina's nose. Now another tip would be if you had a long nose, you could just slightly shadow below the nose, and that would help give the illusion of a shorter nose. Now you've got your reminder cards, and there's a lot of great tips in there for contouring. Now here's Dawn. What I want to do is I want to show you some techniques for under eye dark circles, a little bit of a puff, and then we're going to do some shadowing on how to deal with a fold that slightly goes over on your upper lid. We're going to make it real simple. Okay, first we're going to start with our foundation again. Here we go. Now we're going to blend our colors. And a mistake that women commonly make if there's any kind of an under eye puff or bag is they go too light in their color and in their application, which really just accentuates the problem. Now she has no other makeup on, and I wanted her to sit here with nothing else on so that you could really see the difference. Okay, now slightly turn to me. Now if you need to, you can use this stippling technique we talked about before, where you're just patting over the area. And make sure you blend it into the rest of your foundation or your skin tone.
Now we're going to use some powder to set. Now this is important, just use a light dusting. And remember, if you have a lot of lines around the eyes, you don't want to use too much powder. So I'm just using very little, as you can see here on my puff. I'm pressing it into the puff so it's not going to just be sitting on her skin. And I'm just taking away some of that shine. Okay. Now let's talk a little bit about lining your eyes. If you have a puff or a bag underneath the eye, what you want to do is instead of working where we talked about earlier, higher up in the lash line, you want to go slightly lower down. What this does is it creates the illusion of actually cutting the puff in two. Now here's what I mean. Normally we might be working up here, but here on Dawn, we're going to work just a little bit lower. Now I'm using my pencil to just reduce that puff. Be sure to apply it and then blend it out. Now close your eyes and we're going to do it again on the top, just going down into the lash line, which we've shown you before. Just to thicken the lashes. And we're going to blend. Now open your eyes. Now, what's important here, when you see any kind of a fold over the eye, normally a mistake a lot of women make is they tend to make up with eyeshadow with their eyes closed, and they never get the placement quite right. So if we had Dawn closing her eyes, close your eyes, and she just was doing her makeup herself and she just worked like this, chances are when she opened her eyes, she wouldn't quite have the makeup where it needed to be. So the best thing to do is work with your eye open, keep your eye open. Use your slant tip at the outer portion of the eye. Now here again, I'm using my peach kit, using my very soft browns. I'm just doing some defining at the outer portion of the eye, but I'm actually going right over the fold of the eye, so it's actually reducing it. Now, when you work this way, where I'm reducing it, the fold from the top, and I've used my pencil where I've moved it down a little bit on the puff underneath, this is what's going to give the illusion of giving a little bit more depth to an eye where there's a little bit of a fold already. And the whole key here is really in having the eye open when you're doing your application. Now, once you have your application established, and again, here we are working at the outer portion of the eye in toward the nose, keeping the concentration of color on the outer portion. Close your eyes. You can use your fill-in side for your color. Working lighter in toward the nose. Great, now open your eyes. And again, if a little bit more is needed, just go right over that fold. And that really helps to reduce it. And then be sure to blend. Make sure you really blend at the outer portion. Now, something else to remember here. All of these eyeshadows are very flat in their colors. They're matte. There's no shine. You don't want anything that's too iridescent. If you have a problem with an eye area in terms of like a droopy eye or a fold of skin, you don't want to use an iridescence because it's just going to draw more attention to that area. So you want to keep it very flat, and that's what I'm doing here. Now, let's just put on a little bit of mascara. Again, it's easiest when you have your eye open for your application. Now, these are real subtle techniques, but they're very effective when you're trying to correct a specific problem. I'm going to very quickly just fill in her brows. Seems I can never just work on one section of an eye. When I see this in another area, I could slightly touch up. We're just going to fill in just a bit. Then let's go over with some powder. Now let's take a look. This is before. Now this is after. Now take a look at this woman, Carrie. As you can see, she really has dark under eye circles. Now what you need to do to take care of this problem is you need to go one shade lighter in your foundation, or a half a shade lighter possibly, than the under eye dark circle, and be sure to blend thoroughly with your sponge. This should take care of all your problems. Now let's meet Shirla. Now we're going to talk about minimizing facial lines and wrinkles and how to give you a good head start in not having to put on a little bit too much makeup that's going to really accentuate some of those problems. So let's start with our moisturizer. We take just a little bit of moisturizer, and it's important. I want you to see I'm really just dabbing very little. I'm going to get the excess off on my hand, and I'm just going to very lightly apply in a downward motion over her face with the moisturizer. Now this is absorbed very quickly into the skin, and what it's going to do is create a really nice smooth base for my foundation to go over. Because when you're wanting to minimize lines and wrinkles, you want to use a little bit less makeup. Otherwise, you can almost draw more attention to the problem area. So just a little bit goes a long way. It's absorbed right into the skin. And Shirla's probably feeling right now, this stuff feels great because I don't even know I have it on. Okay, now, something else that's kind of nice to do a little bit on an older skin is to take some of the eye gel repair and take a little bit on your finger and just stipple in toward the nose, just dotting very lightly. And this helps reduce any kind of bags, puffs, and it's great if you wake up in the morning and your eyes are just a little bit puffy. This is going to help take that down. It's a really, really light gel. You're not even going to be able to see that you have it on, and your makeup goes over it great. Okay. Now, let's go over with our toning mist to keep your face feeling really fresh. And now we're ready to put on the foundation. Okay. Now, Shirla has a medium skin tone, so I'm going to be working in the medium kit. And I just want to even out her skin tone. You don't want to add too much, but still give you some of the coverage. Now, when you see any kind of discoloration on the skin, or this goes with freckles as well, you just want to even out the skin tone. Don't feel you need to put down a real heavy base to cover everything on the face. It's kind of nice to have some of the freckles come through. It shows a little bit more of your natural skin. And a mistake that older women commonly make is they just try to cover too much and they apply too heavily, and instead you're drawing more attention. So we're going to be using this half face technique again so that you're going to be able to see the difference. Now here you can see Shirla has short hair, so we want to go right into her hairline and going over the earlobes. And again, these colors are so perfectly blended. The skin tone, it blends right into her skin, so you shouldn't have to go too far down on the neck, so you don't have to worry about ruining any of those pretty white blouses. Okay, now let's work right up in the eye area to cover up any of the under eye dark, any kind of puffiness. And you're working in toward the nose, just slightly stippling, just patting in the area. Remember, look and see here, you can see a very little foundation. A little bit's going to go a long way. And when you're applying, you can apply with the makeup, and then when you need to blend out, use a clean side. You can slightly go over the eyelid, close your eyes. And this will take away from any blue or discoloration that you have above the eyes, if you want to just lighten them up. And this will help open the eye up as well. Okay, now open your eye. Great. And don't be afraid to get the sponge right up to that lash line underneath the eye. And go all around toward the nose. Now let's powder. Now again, when you're using your powder, and this is really important to remember when you're minimizing facial lines and wrinkles, the biggest mistake you can make is use too much powder and it will just really draw more attention. So very lightly, and this is again why I use a puff, because I take the powder, I press it right into the puff, I get the excess off on my hand, and then I just go to the face. So I'm just really dusting over my foundation and I'm taking away any shine. Now you can tell the makeup's gone over fine. We had on moisturizer, we had eye gel, and it's still, there's no trace. That's what's so great about the products. They're not greasy. Now, if we had something real greasy, a heavy night cream or something around the eyes, you wouldn't be able to get this flat, matte look. Okay. Now we've prepared her face, we've evened out her skin tone. Let's just do a little work with the eyebrows. Using the taupe pencil, and this is another very important thing to remember. A woman, when you're getting a little older, sometimes you can tend to, when you're working on your eyebrows, using the arch, which is the midpoint of the eyebrow, really create too high of an arch. You need to really round it off and keep it very smooth. And always be sure to blend. Okay, now let's go over some of that with the eyebrow gel. And we're gonna go over with a little bit of powder. Now let's just brush, keep it very soft. As you can see for Shirla's coloring here, I'm working in the taupes, very light browns. I don't want anything that's gonna look hard. Okay, now let's start defining her eyes a little bit. We're gonna use a dark brown pencil. Close your eyes. Now remember, when the face has a little bit of more lines or wrinkles, you're gonna have to hold the eye with a little more pressure, hold it taut. Don't be afraid to hold some of those lines and just pull them out a little bit, because you really need to get the pencil down right into some of those problem areas. Always apply and then just blend it right out. Now I'm sure by now you can see that I use very little product and I'm always blending it right away. So you want to just always remember to apply and blend. It's real important. Okay, now open your eyes. Now we're going to do a little bit of work underneath the eye. Okay, you look straight ahead. Remember, when you're doing your own eyes, and everybody's gonna have a way that's different when they're doing their own eyes and where it is that it's comfortable for you to look. Some people like feel very comfortable looking straight up, straight across, wherever it's really comfortable for you. And it's always easiest when you're working with pencils to work off to the side as opposed to straight on. You'll find that you won't blink as much. Okay, now I'm making this very smoky, and I'm just blending. Now let's move on to our eyeshadow. Now this is another really important part. When you're working with an eye that has any kind of a fold or a droop or a puffy eye or lines around the eyes, it's very important that you stay away from anything that's too iridescent. You really need to work in very flat, matte colors. So what you want to do, we're working with our slant tip. You're working your flat, matte brown, and we're gonna start getting the excess off on our hand. And we're gonna work at the outer portion. Now, as you can see, some dustings fell. A good tip for you to prevent that happening is you can work this way, holding a Kleenex so that when any kind of powder falls, it'll fall right onto the Kleenex. Or if you're having a little bit of difficulty in creating this shaping, which I'm gonna talk about now, which is your V shaping right here on the eye, Take the corner of your sponge, hold it up to the corner of the eye, and work from the outer portion of the eye in toward the nose. Now, this is real important, especially on an eye where the eye is tending to droop down. We all get a little older and the eye starts going downward. If you start here and just keep working outward, you're never going to change that. But if you start here and work in, you're going to correct the problem. You'll also notice I'm getting the powder right here on my sponge as opposed to on her face. Now, what Cheryl is doing, and this is important to remember to do when you're doing your makeup, especially if there's any kind of a fold, you need to look in the mirror and keep your eye open and place it in the area that needs it the most, as opposed to closing your eyes. Close your eyes, Cheryl. If Cheryl kept her eyes closed all the time and just did her makeup this way, which a lot of women tend to do, and then opened and it wasn't quite where she needed it, it's good to look straight in the mirror, have your eyes open, and place the makeup where it's going to be needed most. Remember, always soften out the outer portion, keeping it real soft. Now I'm keeping my darker color on the outer portion of the eye, and then I'm going to use my lighter shade, dusting off the excess in the center. Close your eyes. The reason for that is we're just blending. We want to keep it so that there's an evenness. You don't really see where one color ends and the other begins. It's important, especially for an older woman, that you don't have a real light color, a dark color, another color. I mean, that's very dated. You just want very soft colors that blend one into the other. Okay, well, let's add a little more liner. Close your eyes. Great. Now I'm going to add just a little more to the eyebrow. Look straight up. Now also, something else to really be careful of is make sure, so we want to keep the eye open. We don't want to draw any unnatural attention, especially for you older women. Don't put any of the dark color on the inside rim of the eye. Put it down lower in the lash line. And what's especially effective is if you do have some slight puff or bag underneath the eye, what you want to do is, instead of working too high up in the lash line, move a little bit lower down to reduce that puff. And you'll see that it actually will cut the puff in half. Now let's go on to mascara. I'm going to just lightly curl her lashes. Some of you will like to do that. I think Cheryl is going to panic a little here. It's really a great tool if you just use a little pressure on the tips to help curl, to help open up the eyes. Now let's use our black mascara. And let's even thicken those lashes a little bit. That's what this is so great for, not only for the eyebrows, but for the lashes, to thicken them. Again, it's real important. You don't want to do too much in terms of your mascara, drawing unnatural attention to your eyes. A good rule to remember is if you have a problem area to the face, don't draw the attention to the problem area. Okay, now what we do is to comb through the lashes. I'm gonna again wrap the Kleenex around my finger, take my comb, and go right through the lashes. This gets the excess off. What's great too is sometimes as we get older, our lashes tend to fall out, so that's what's so great about having this gel, because it will also thicken those lashes, so you'll have a little bit nicer coverage with your mascara. Well, let's talk about blush. We really just want to do a light dusting of blush, real soft. As you can see, I'm using my peach tones, and I'm just blending the colors together, getting the excess off on my hand, and I'm just going to go over her face, her jawline, her blush line, into her hairline, down the nose, a little bit even over her eyes. And the blush is just going to even everything out. It's great. You don't want to use too much powder, though. Just enough to give a little bit of some color without all the texture of the powder. Okay, now let's go on to lips. Now, what's also great about this eye gel repair is it's not just for eyes. It's for fine, dry lines around the eyes, but also around the mouth. So take a little bit again on your finger, and I use very little, and just go right around the mouth and blend it in. This really helps any fine, dry lines. Just makes the lip pencil go on smoother and your lipstick. Okay. Now you can take your sponge, blend it in. Now let's line our lips. Okay, you really want to go with a very soft, neutral color. Keep your mouth closed. Stay within the natural lip line. And especially if there's lines around the mouth, you want to be very careful to not go with any kind of a dark line, because that would just, again, draw more attention to the problem area. So you can now fill in with color. Okay, turn toward me. And when you're doing your lips, you need to look at it from different angles. Straight on, tilt the head up just a little bit to make sure you're getting a straight lip line underneath. Just part your, open your mouth a little bit and make sure you're getting into the corners of the mouth. Okay, now close your mouth. Always when you're doing your lips and you're ending, keep your mouth closed, because believe it or not, it's very different. The lip line's very different with the mouth closed as it is when it's slightly parted or open. Now this may look kind of strange seeing Shirla sitting here with just half of her face done, but when I turn her around and you see half, I want you to really see the difference. Then maybe what we'll do is we'll let Shirla make up the other half of her face, and we can see how beautiful she looks. Now here I've filled in just with my pencil, and I'm gonna go over it with my lipstick. Now this is important when you're using your lipstick. Again, these colors are wonderful because they're all very flat and matte. You wanna keep it real neutral, very light. Okay, close your mouth. Now this is one case where I love my powder lips. But if you've got a lot of fine lines and dry lines, fine lines around the mouth, stay away from the iridescence around the mouth. And after you've applied your lipstick, if you need to go back and just apply a little bit more of your pencil, that's fine. Okay, now we're gonna just finish off with just another real light dusting of some powder. Give a little bit more color, some blush. Now let's take a look at before and after. Here, let's take a look all the way before. Now let's look after. I think she looks great.
Well, Kathleen, we're just about out of time. You know, we've covered a lot of ground, and we've covered all the basic techniques you need and a lot of the individual problems that many of us have to deal with. Now, you'll find there are several problem areas that we didn't demonstrate that are covered in your reminder cards. Now, those cards use techniques that we've covered in this tape and are pretty much self-explanatory. Like I mentioned in the beginning, if some of these techniques seem a little slower or harder than what you're used to doing, don't panic. You've been practicing your way for years. It'll only take a few weeks of practice, and these techniques will result in both a better and faster application of makeup. Most important, don't be afraid to experiment. It's only makeup. It washes right off, and just have fun.
Watching Victoria's techniques and using her makeup should tell you that she probably knows more about what works best with a woman's face than any other cosmetic company president in America. But more important than all of this is a side of Victoria that I wish you could see. She's someone who really, really cares, which makes her such a good friend. And she cares about what goes into her products and onto your face, because it's going onto her face too. She cares about how well they work and what women have to spend to buy her products. And I like that she cares about animals to not use them for product testing. With her products, you'll always have the confidence of knowing You're getting something that's been developed by a woman who spent her whole life helping others to look more naturally beautiful, a woman who really cares. Thank you for joining us. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks, Victoria.
Thank you, Kathleen.